डियर स्टूडेंट्स, मंगल मैत्री। टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एंड द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स इन इकोनॉमिक्स। सो व्हेन एवर वी स्टार्ट एनी सब्जेक्ट, एनी टॉपिक, वी हैव टू डिफाइन इट। द डेफिनेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम देयर हैज बीन चेंज इन द डेफिनेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, द फादर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एडम स्मिथ डिफाइंड इकोनॉमिक्स एज द साइंस ऑफ वेल्थ, means it is a wealth oriented definition. Adam Smith says that economics is an inquiry into the nature and causes of wealth of nation. It means he defined it as the science of wealth, but in the due course Dr. Marshall criticized it that it lacks somewhere the mankind, means it has some mankind like situation which is neglected here. Only it has concern with the wealth, means कि इसका जो है सरोकार, सामाजिक सरोकार एक तरीके से मानवता के साथ, वो उसको नहीं दिया गया है एडम स्मिथ के द्वारा। उन्होंने इसको धन का विज्ञान बना के रख दिया है। तो इट इज वेल्थ, साइंस ऑफ वेल्थ, वेल्थ ओरिएंटेड डेफिनेशन, बट मार्शल क्रिटिसाइज इट ऑन दिस बेसिस एंड मार्शल डिफाइंड इट एज द एज इकोनॉमिक्स एज द मैन काइंड Study of mankind, in the ordinary business of life. Study of mankind in the ordinary business of life. It means he concerned it, related it with the material welfare. So it is the material welfare definition given by Dr. Marshall. And thereafter, Dr. Robbins, he also criticized it on the ground that it neglected or it missed the concept of scarcity. The scarcity-oriented definition. What does scarcity mean? Scarcity means that the demand for the things are greater than their supply. It means it is in scarce quantity. It was missed in both the definitions, and Robbins introduced this definition with the scarcity. Means economics studies the scarce things. Thus, Dr. Samuelson, Peterson, etc. also criticized this definition, and they gave the growth-oriented definition. We know that today we see everything in terms of growth, industrial growth, GDP growth, growth in agriculture, growth in population, etc. So growth oriented definition was given by Samuelson, Peterson, etc. So in this way we can say that from time to time there has been a change in the definition of economics. But a comprehensive definition we can give that economics is the subject matter. Economics is the subject matter that deals with the scarce resources, that deals with the rational management of scarce resources in such a way that the economic gains can be maximized at micro level and at macro level. So we can say that economics is the subject matter that deals with the rational management of scarce resources in such a way that the economic gains can be maximized at the micro level and macro level. This kind of definition can be given as comprehensive. Rational management means to make the best use of the resources. Scarce resources means the resources are less in comparison to their demand. Economic gains can be maximized at micro level, means individual levels, individual producer, individual consumer, and at also at the macro level where the social welfare is maximized. such as archive work for tribe work. Like this we can define it. Now the economic activities, about the economic activities, the production, consumption, saving, investment, distributions, all these are the economic activities. If I ask you generally what is production, your answer will be production means kuch utpadan karna, to produce something. But in terms of economics we say that production is the creation of utility. Creation of utility. Creation of utility means such as you can see the clay or soil and the potter make utensils out of this. Means कि कोई कुम्हार जो है वो मिट्टी से कोई घड़ा सुराई कुछ भी ऐसा बर्तन बना सकता है, तो उसने उस मिट्टी में उपयोगिता यानी कि यूटिलिटी पैदा कर, दैट इज द क्रिएशन ऑफ यूटिलिटी इन द मैटर. इन सच ए वे वी कैन डिफाइन प्रोडक्शन एज द क्रिएशन ऑफ यूटिलिटी इन द मैटर. वी कैन ऑल्सो डिफाइन इट एज द वैन रॉ मेटेरियल इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू फिनिश गुड्स, दस क्रिएशन ऑफ यूटिलिटी और द रॉ मेटेरियल कन्वर्टेड इन टू फिनिश गुड, दैट इज प्रोडक्शन. Second thing is consumption. Consumption is that when this utility is being used by the consumers, it is consumption. Use of utility. Use of utility. Use of utility. Here I would also like to define the producer. Who is producer? Producer is an economic agent who produces goods and services for earning their income. In the same way consumption, use of utility in the matter, and consumer is the economic agent who uses goods and services for direct satisfaction of wants. In such a way producer is concerned with production, consumer concerned with consumption. Saving is that part of income which is not consumed. Part of income which is not consumed. Which is not consumed. So savings part of income which is not consumed. What is investment? If we purchase anything for our home, that is not investment. Suppose if I purchase a car, it is not investment. Until or unless I use it for the further production of services, such as a taxi operator purchase the car, that is investment. So investment is the expenditure made on purchase of capital goods. That is the fixed asset of the producer, such as a farmer purchases tractor. The tractor is the capital of the farmer, and what he is doing, he is making expenditure on purchase of tractor. It means he is doing investment. Now the distribution. Distribution can be defined as the personal distribution and functional distribution. Personal distribution means how the income and output is distributed among the households. That is personal distribution. And the functional distribution, the factors of production which are associated with the production of anything, such as land, labor, capital, entrepreneur, all these work and they got the output. How the income generated, such as the rent is generated by the land, rent. Interest by capital, wages by the labor, and profit by entrepreneur. How these four incomes are distributed among the land, labor, capital, entrepreneur. This is the functional distribution. So distribution can be classified as the personal distribution as well as the functional distribution. So in this topic we finish it. Thank you.